Welcome to this last tutorial for the course English 4. Again, we're going to be reviewing some of the grammar that you find in your book Ventures 4. Today we're going to look at the present, future, and real conditional, and the future real conditional. Let's start with the present, future, and real conditional. I have put these two together, the present and the future, because we're going to be using the same structure. This unreal conditional is also known as the second conditional, okay? And we're going to be using this conditional sentence to talk about situations that are not possible. Now, in the sentence, you're going to have two clauses, the if clause and the result clause. Remember that these clauses are going to be separated by a comma. Let's take a look at the structure. In the if clause, or in the first clause, we're going to have the past tense, and in the second clause, or the result clause, we're going to have would, or could, or might, plus the verb. And they're going to be separated by the comma. Let's take a look at the example. If I played the guitar, I would be in a band. Played is in the past tense, okay? And I would be in a band. In this case, we're using would, the result clause. Now, something particular about these sentences is that you can switch the clauses. I can write the result clause at the beginning and the if clause at the end, as you can see here in the example. I would be in a band if I play the guitar. But there is a difference in this sentence. We're not using the comma anymore. So always remember, if you start with the if clause, you're going to have a comma after it. But if we're starting the sentence with the result clause, you don't need the comma after it. Examples. If I spoke German, I would travel to Germany. Again, take a look at the verb. Spoke, past tense. Would plus the verb, would travel. Here, I'm switching again these two clauses. I would travel to Germany if I spoke German. If you change the order, you're going to still have the same meaning. Next example. If Peter knew how to drive, he would buy a car. Again, let's take a look at the verb, past tense. In the second clause, we have would plus the verb, okay, would buy. Again, I'm changing the order of this sentence. He would buy a car if Peter knew how to drive. Okay, future real conditional. This is also known as the first conditional. It's called the real conditional because there is a possibility that it may happen. It is also formed by two clauses, the if clause and the result clause. And again, these two clauses are separated by a comma. The structure. In the first part, you're going to have the present tense. And in the second clause, you're going to have will plus the verb, which is the future. Example. If you travel abroad, you will need your passport. If you travel, again, we're using the present tense. And in the second clause, we're using the future, will need. Again, since this is a conditional sentence, you can change the order of these two clauses. There's a mistake right here. It should be, you will need your passport if you travel abroad. Again, this is you, not you. Okay, two more examples. If I get a raise, I will buy a new car. I will buy a new car if I get a raise. If there is a discount, Maria will buy two pairs of shoes. Maria will buy two pairs of shoes if there is a discount. And that's the end for this last tutorial. Thank you.